Anybody care to share his or her favorite movie? Nobody?
Wreck-It Ralph.
Wreck-It Ralph?
That's a good movie. Movie.
It just came out. Anybody else?
Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings? Which one?
Really? They're all just really great.
They're just phenomenal.
Okay, live action film, why not? Anybody else?
The Incredibles.
The Incredibles. Ooh. Okay, so that's a great movie. Okay, so I'm gonna tell you what I do. I work at Blue Sky Studios. We have made to date 7 films, and I want to share with you the trailer for the upcoming movie. I hope you all like it.
Making 3 to 4 times more money than they used to 20 years ago. And it's because
business is now more worldwide. When we make movies, or like when you make movies like The Avengers, people see them here in the United States, but they're also seeing them across the whole world. And you have an audience that is not just in this country, but throughout the world. I want to tell you how I got into the business of making movies. I was just being a happy engineer cartoonist, and then one day I went to see this film. I don't know if you know this scene from this film. This is Star Wars, another one sequel. Star Wars: Attack of the Clones. The film came out in 2002, and when I watched this film, I said, "There's something wrong here." And maybe, well, besides the acting of Hayden Christensen, the thing that I thought was wrong is that the waterfalls were going too fast. And so, if you sit down and you like work this out, you can measure that. You know, Natalie Portman is about 3 feet tall sitting down, right? And from that, you can sort of backtrack and figure out, well, what's the distance to this rock over here if she's this tall? And from that, you can figure out that these falls should be about 150 feet tall. It's something you can do with yourself, you know, just go frame by frame. And then you can figure out, you know, if you track one piece of water going all the way, it's easier to track it going up. You can count the number of frames that something will go up. And you can work out, you know, through this equation. There'll be a test at the end. This is the position of an object as a function of time, given gravity. And if you guys have had algebra, you recognize this is a quadratic equation. So you can plug in, 2 seconds for the time. You can plug in 32 feet per second squared as your gravity, and you get a half. And you can work out that this actual waterfall is only 64 feet tall. And so, to me, I was the only person coming out of the movie talking about the waterfall and how it was wrong, which quickly ostracized my friends until I found new friends in the animation industry. And so now, every time, you know, a simple example of what I do every day is I take the effects and the things that get created in the trailer that you just saw, and I make sure that they are all correct to scale, that we're not breaking any laws of physics, because as soon as you do that, then you can jar someone out of the story. You know, if you're seeing something that's going too quick. And obviously, you know, I went back and I checked my work, and you can go and look at a YouTube clip, and you can find a real waterfall, and you can count the number of frames, and you know, a lot of these waterfalls throughout the world, there are known height. And then you can backtrack, you know, what the correct time should be. So anyway. So that's my simple explanation for the kind of math that I use that you can do too, the kind of example that you can do at home. Use math to become a film critic, and so on. All right, so now I'm going to